I believe they want to divide our communities here between the Muslims and the Christians. And as a government, I don't think we will tolerate that. We will follow them diligently until we make sure that we arrest those people that were involved. You look again, they want also to, because there was a doctor whom we identified last evening, and a teacher, they also want to make it look like the non-locals cannot work in this region, so that we have an incident that we had last time of teachers and then other than locals vacating the country. I want to assure all the government officers, we will make sure that we secure them. This is a case of its own, and I would wish that us, even the local communities, we need to wake up and say no to what is happening. Because I was being told there was a guy who kept on moving from one seat, talking to the conductor and the driver as they were moving. And in that process, we arrested that driver of the bus and the conductor, and we will look for more. Because these people just want to put a wedge so that all of us will become like we are enemies and we don't want to move to that direction. So we will pursue them, whichever design they put in place. And that's why the local leaders, I'm happy they were here. They have told me they are not going to any other function until they empathize with the families and ask the people of Wajir here.
County Commissioner, this incident happened in my constituency. I am Ahmed Bashenegal, Member of Parliament for Tarbes Constituency. I also condemn in the strongest term possible the incident that has occurred in my constituency. And this has been routine once in a while. Every year, we normally get this kind of incident. We normally work with the security apparatus to forestall or to stop this incident, which will be occur. Now, from now, I think we need to change our strategies and think outside the box to look for possible ways to completely stop these incidences that occur in my constituency and in the county as a whole. I send also my condolences to the families that have lost their loved ones.
To condemn, as my colleagues have already condemned, we cannot be condemning every day in and day out, and send condolences of messages. This time round, we are going back to the drawing board as leaders. We cannot allow such malpractices to continue in our soil. We will sit with the communities affected, the areas that are affected, and talk to the leaders, all leaders, irrespective of their position in the society. Let us all cooperate together to stem out this menace.